Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, and in today's video we are going to talk about my GMAT preparation journey for a 710 score, and I am also going to include some tips and tricks for the preparation, so stay tuned till the end of the video. First, let me talk about GMAT, how it works as an exam. It may come off as somewhat easier compared to CAT and ZAT in the first glance. When you start official guide and you glance through all the questions, they may seem easier compared to ZAT and CAT. But believe me, that's not the case. GMAT is somewhat of a different sort of exam, and it requires a lot of self-awareness and practice. First, let me talk about how scoring happens in GMAT, because that will put a lot of things into perspective. GMAT is an adaptive exam. By that I mean is when you start the test, the first question that is thrown to you in each of the section is going to be of a medium difficulty level. If you do it correctly, then the next question will be higher up in terms of difficulty and also in terms of the score. If you get the next question wrong, then the subsequent difficulty level will keep on decreasing, and also the marks. So it adapts to the way you are performing during the exam. Hence, it is quite important that you increase your accuracy rate when you are preparing for GMAT, and I would suggest an accuracy rate of 90 to 95% if you want to get a sure shot high score. By that I mean is somewhat around 700 and beyond. If you have given any other exams such as ZAT or CAT, it may seem like that GMAT is way easier compared to that, but believe me, that's not the case, because GMAT is an adaptive exam. You need to focus on an exhaustive preparation. You cannot leave certain chapter and focus on certain else. You need to achieve an accuracy rate of 90 to 95%. And for doing that, you need to focus on getting most of the questions right and excel at most of these sections and excel in different types of questions. When I used to prepare for IIT, I remember in the math section, I focused only on calculus and coordinate, because those were the most prominent questions that were asked in that exam. That is not something that you can do in GMAT. You need to be very exhaustive when you are trying to prepare for GMAT, and also you need to attack all your weaknesses. Any area that you are weak in, you need to focus more on it. GMAT being an adaptive test, they adapt to your weakness. So if you started doing some permutation and combination questions wrong, they will throw more of such questions to you. So you need to work a lot on your weakness. So again, GMAT is a lot about self-awareness, working on your own weakness and excelling. And then again, the second thing is that it is a lot about understanding the patterns, understanding the different types of questions that are being asked, how the solution can be approached for them, and a lot of practice. Having understood how GMAT works as an exam, I want to focus on the next step in this video, which is the timeline for preparation. And there's no right answer to it. A lot of people come to me asking whether 3 months will be enough, whether 4 months will be enough. There's no right answer to it. It all depends on the person, what kind of background you have, how much practice you have had before. If you have given any other competitive exam such as CAT or ZAT, it may be a bit easier for you, because you'll be able to score much higher in the quant section and you can focus just on the verbal section. So it all depends. But in any case, whichever kind of background you have, whatever score that you get in the first test that you give, I think 6 to 2 months time period is something that will work for everyone. If you get a very poor score in the initial test, you have given somewhere around 560, 600, still a 6 month time period will be enough to get you to a 700 level. And if you get a really good score in the first attempt that you have given in a practice test, you will need just 1.5 months for practice and preparation before giving the GMAT. For me, the timeline was 4 months. I went for a more relaxed time period because I was working in a full-time job and I had to take time aside from that to prepare for GMAT. I'm making another video which shows the timeline and what was my routine during that time period. You can go through it if you want to follow a similar routine, or you just want to understand how you can prepare for a competitive exam while upholding a full-time job. Now I want to get into the specific of those 4 months. So first of all, there's something that I would like to discuss, which is quite important. In most of the GMAT forums, such as GMAT Club, Beat the GMAT, you will get the suggestion that you first need to give a practice test, then understand your weak areas and work your entire preparation from there. That is not something that I did, and that is something that I would suggest to everyone, that before giving a practice test by official guide, work through it once, finish the entire book, understand the pattern, because GMAT is an exam of practice and pattern. Once you have understood the question type, how to tackle those kind of questions, then it would be advisable to take a GMAT practice test. I'm saying this because initially, if you give the GMAT test and you are not aware of all the patterns of all the types of questions are there, because GMAT is very specific in the method of solution that GMAT is very specific about the method in which their questions need to be approached. If you are not aware of it, you might end up with a very poor score in the first practice test, and that may demoralize you. So the first tip here is go through the official guide and then take a practice test. After I took the practice test, I think I scored somewhere around 600, 630, somewhere around that. And I understood I'm not still at that level and I would need at least 3 months of practice from there before giving GMAT. A lot of people also recommend that you should book a GMAT date, and that will inspire you to work harder, to study harder. But I won't suggest that. Again, that is step number two. Don't book your GMAT until and unless you know how much time it will require you to get enough practice and feel confident. After analyzing the first test, I realized the areas that need to be worked upon. For me, sentence correction was that area. Sentence correction was that area which was bringing my score down by an enormous level. I realized that that is something that I need to work a lot more compared to the other section. I was pretty good at CR, so I thought that I should not focus on it a lot. In reading comprehension, I realized speed was something that I need to work upon, and also speed was lacking mainly in the science and technology reading comprehension. So I thought that I should focus more on those type of reading comprehension. I was pretty good at maths except for one chapter, that was permutation and combination. I was getting most of their questions wrong, so I thought that I should revise the basic of it from NCERT books. And for the other section, that was data sufficiency. Problem solving I was pretty good at, but for data sufficiency I realized I wasn't doing that well, maybe because that is something that I didn't practice for in any of the Indian competition, and I felt that I need to work a lot more on that. Once I realized these are the areas that I need to work upon, I purchased additional resources for these areas. I got reading comprehension from Manhattan. I got sentence correction book from Manhattan. And for maths also, I got an advanced mathematics book from Manhattan. Aside from that, I purchased EG Maths verbal section. I think at that time it was for somewhere around 12,000. And I purchased the entire verbal section rather than just the sentence correction, because I felt I can uplift the entire verbal score by a certain level. So I started focusing on the verbal section, with main focus being on sentence correction. That was almost my 1 month where I realized my weaknesses. I went through OG1s, and in the next 1 month, I focused on the areas that were weak, the areas that I talked about, the books that I purchased, and I focused on working through those concepts, those books. And by the end of 2 months, I started giving a lot of practice tests. So the third and fourth month comprises of a lot of revision and a lot of practice tests. It's really important to give practice tests once a week so that you are aware what are the areas you have improved upon, what are the areas that needs improvement, and also you can become way more disciplined. I used to give one practice test every week. for the last 2 months of the preparation time period. Aside from the test, in the third month, I focused a lot on the toughest question. I focused on toughest question in problem solving, toughest RC, 700 level questions in CR, SC. These are all different sections that you can find in GMAT Club, and you can work through the concepts, read through the comments, and understand those questions and the pattern really well. And that's what I did in the third month of preparation. In the final month of preparation, I focused a lot on giving practice tests. I increased the number of practice tests that I was giving from 1 to 2 because I wanted to get into the discipline and attain that focus that is required to sit in an exam for 4 hours and still not be distracted or not to get tired during that time period. Again, the most important tip of the video is, guys, please focus on official guide. In the final month of preparation, I went back to official guide. I revised all the questions. I solved the entire book twice in the final month of preparation. I'm saying this because a lot of people feel that official guide is quite easy and they need to work upon more tough questions, but that's not the case. Official guide is enough for getting you up to a score of 700. You can consult the other resources that I have mentioned, and I'll also mention the rest of the resources that I used in a separate video. Please stay tuned for it. But again, coming back to the point, official guide is quite good. It is the questions that are there on official guide are the closest to what you will encounter in the actual GMAT. I also went on to purchase 2 more tests from MBA.com, and in the final month of preparation, I gave all those 4 tests twice so that I am more accustomed to a GMAT-like question and a GMAT-like environment. This is a simple cycle that I wanted to include in this video, which I didn't shoot before. It comprises of study the concept, solve multiple practice questions on that, give some practice test, analyze your mistakes, be it concept related, be it speed related, and then continue the loop. I hope you guys like this video. Please do mention in your comments if you have any doubts, any follow-up questions. I will make sure that I go through the each one of them personally and answer questions that are more pertinent to your GMAT journey. I'm also going to keep on making similar videos, so don't forget to subscribe to this channel. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up, and all the best for your GMATs.